Hi, today we are in BMW and we're going to test and review this little scanner. This is Foxwell NT200C. It's a basic OBD2 scanner, and we are going to check how it works in BMW, if it detects any faults, how the live data looks here, and what are the other functions that are available on this little device. But before that, let's just say that in the box you will have this device. There's a user manual, well illustrated, few languages inside, and an USB cable for software updates. First of all, you can press enter to go to the scan mode, to the diagnostic mode, or up or down to go to settings, to setup. And here you can select language, you have few to select from. And other thing that you can choose is measurement units. We have metric and contrast of the display. You can adjust that if you have some difficulties seeing the display. Okay, so let's go back. Now let's press enter, and the device already connected to the car. It's showing that there are no codes in the car. There are some monitors available. And we are in the diagnostic menu. Over here we can read clear codes, see some live data on the data stream, see the freeze frame. If we have some codes, we can see the freeze frame when the code appeared. And we have the readiness monitor and some vehicle information over here. So let's start with the live data. Let's go over here. And the device scans the car for available PIDs, and each PID is one of the engine parameters that we can see over here. DTC count 0, that means that we have no error codes pending, and we have for example mass air pressure in kilopascals, and that's 102, that's about atmospheric pressure, and when I rev the car it should go slightly up. Yeah, 140, 130, 110, and goes back to the default. Okay, let's scroll down to see what's else available in this car. RPM, speed sensor, intake temperature, mass airflow. One thing that I don't like is when you scroll all the way down to the end of the list, it goes back up, but when you press up, it doesn't go back to the last position. So if you know that something is at the bottom, you need to scroll down all the way to the bottom. And if you miss that, if you press one time too much and you go back up and you want to go back, there's no going back. You need to scroll down again. So that's a little inconvenience over here. Okay, so let's go to car information. Let's see what we can find over there. And okay, you need to press shut the engine, leave the ignition on, and we can check vehicle VIN, calibration ID. And I have to say that I checked this in other cars, and in one car, in Volvo, I had problem to see the VIN, but I contacted the Foxbook and they developed an update for this in 3 or 4 days and sent me the update. So that's impressive that they can develop updates so fast and fix those little bugs in a matter of days. Okay, as I said, in BMW I have no codes, so let's go to a different car. So here we are in Volvo V50, and I know that there should be some faults in this car. So let's connect to this car, and it connects pretty quickly. Okay, we have 4 codes found in the car. So right now let's read them. You can select your vehicle manufacturer. So some of the manufacturer specific codes will have descriptions, not all of them, but some of them. So let's go all the way down to Volvo. I would just love to press up once to go to the end of the list, but I have to scroll down all the way over here. And I have fuel pressure related faults. This is the first one. second one, this is the manufacturer specific. It's, it starts with the P1, so it's not a generic DTC code, but it's specific for this this car. And there's no description, sadly, for this code, but I know that this is also related to the fuel pressure. Second one, third one, and fourth one. Okay, all four codes are related to the fuel pressure valve. So now let's check if I can clear those codes. Let's leave the on and let's try again. Clear codes. Are you sure? Yes, codes clear. Let's read them again. No codes found. Okay, so it works. Okay, to sum it up, this is a really nice device. I like it. It's small, compact. The screen is black and white, so you will not have any graphs over here. So this is the screen limitation. But for the entry base device, this is, I would say, it's a very good good piece of hardware. And the only thing that I don't like is the scrolling. As I said, to go to the end of the list, you cannot go one time up to go to the end. But the missing scrolling feature is a software problem, and they can easily solve it with a software update. As I said before, they are working really fast when it comes to the updates. If you report your concerns, your bugs, they most likely will fix it within a few days and release new software, new firmware that you can install into the device to have it working as you expected. If you want to buy one of those, check the link in the description below this video. Check my other tutorials, give me thumbs up if this review helped you, and see you in future videos. Bye.